Dear students, in this video lecture we are going to discuss log distance path loss model and log normal shadowing model. In the last video lecture we discussed about the free space propagation model, where we discussed the terms related to free space, that is estimation of the power received by the receiving antenna, that is by the receiver, where it is observed that or discussed the received power get reduced logarithmically or the losses or the path loss degradation is also logarithmic. But apart from this loss, one more term is need to consider, that is the exponent factor due to the environmental parameters, and one more term, that is random parameter. So by assuming these terms, the analysis is given in these two models, that is log distance path loss model and log normal shadowing model. So log distance path loss model, so here the average large scale path loss for an arbitrary TR separation distance is expressed as a function of distance by using path loss exponent factor n. So this path loss exponent factor is due to the environmental parameters. So we can write the expression path loss at distance d, that is distance between transmitter and receiver, is directly proportional to d by d0 raised to n. So d is nothing but the distance between the transmitter and receiver, and d0 is the reference distance which is assumed in between the transmitter and receiver. Also we can express this expression in dB. So path loss in dB is equal to path loss, that is PL bar of d0 plus 10 n log, that is the exponent factor log d by d0. So here PL bar of d indicates the average large scale path loss at a distance d, also denoted in dB. So the value of n depends on the propagation environment. For free space it is 2, and if suppose obstructions are there at that time, it has a large value. So this exponent factor is due to the obstructions. In free space it is assumed 2, and depending on the variations in the environment, the values of n get changed. So here we will see the path losses or path loss exponent for different environments. So different environments are given. So in this table we can able to see two columns are there. The first column which gives the type of the environment, and in the second column the exponent value, that is path loss exponent n term. So for free space, the exponent factor is 2. For urban area, cellular radio network based area, it is observed that it is in between 2.7 to 3.5. Third, shadowed urban cellular radio, it is in between 3 to 5. In buildings, line of sight, the exponent factor is in between 1.6 to 1.8. So in building, line of sight means, if suppose the height of the transmitting antenna and height of the receiving antenna are same or exact line of sight is there, but the transmitter and receiver exactly located on same floor and the transmitting and receiving antenna surrounded by the obstructions like the wooden partitions, brick walls. So depending on the obstructions, the value of n will change from 1.6 to 1.8. Next environment obstructed in building, if suppose transmitter and receiver surrounded by some buildings, so at that time more losses are observed and at that time the exponent factor is in between 4 to 6. If suppose transmitter and receiver is located in factories or in industries, so at that time the exponent factor will change 2 to 3. So depending on the type of the factory, so suppose textile mill is there, is any foundry industry is there, rice mill is there. So depending on the type of the factory or industry, the exponent value again get changed. Then the selection of the reference distance that we discussed in previous expression, that is d naught, where the minimum losses in that expression d indicates the actual distance between the transmitter and receiver, and d naught is the sample distance or reference distance. Then the selection of the reference distance for the analysis of the models. So in case of large coverage cellular system or mobile cellular networks, it is observed that the reference distance is assumed 1 kilometer approximately, or commonly it is assumed 1 kilometer. And in microcellular system, much smaller distance are used, as much as 100 meter or is in between 100 meter, 1 meter to 100 meter. So microcellular means, in case of indoor applications, personal communication system, the sample distance is assumed minimum 1 meter or 100 meter, maximum 100 meter, depending on the coverage area of the particular indoor application. And in case of mobile cellular network, where the coverage area is in the range of kilometers, that it tens hundreds of kilometer, so at that time the reference distance is 1 kilometer. Then important term related to this reference distance. So this reference distance should always be in far field of antenna, so that near field effect do not alter the reference path loss. So as we discussed in last video lecture, two fields are mainly observed in between transmitting and receiving antenna, that is far field region and near field region. So according to that, the reference distance is assumed. So reference distance should be in far field of antenna, that is the antennas are designed to cover maximum distance. Now the second model, log normal shadowing, where the environmental conditions are considered in the analysis. In last model, log distance path loss model, we have considered the exponent factor n depending on the environment, plus one more term is need to consider for analysis, that is randomness of the environment, which is the responsible to fluctuate the radio wave. So in this expression we can able to see, which is derived in last path loss model, that is the path loss in terms of the exponent factor n and path loss in dB. So this expression does not consider the fact the surrounding environment may be vastly different at two locations having the same TR separation distance. That means the transmitting antenna surrounded by the buildings or any other obstructions and the receiving antenna, so at different locations you will find different environment, and due to the environment or surrounding environment, again the variations in the radio wave. So this leads to measurement that are different than predicted value obtained using above equation. That means the term or expression were written in the last model is not suitable in every application. That is, take simple example, if suppose the TR separation distance, if suppose 1 kilometer, then the assumptions for the 1 kilometer separated communication systems are not same for the 1 kilometer separated another communication system due to the surrounding environment. So the measured values for the received power for the first example, if you compare with the second example, you will find the power values, received power values are different. So the measurement shows that for any value of d, the path loss, that is PL of d in dB at particular location, is random and distributed normally. So we cannot predict the path loss and received power at the same TR separation distance due to the random environment. then the previous expression we are going to consider with the random factor, that is x sigma. So the path loss in dB we can write is equal to path loss at distance d plus x sigma, and path loss in dB at TR separation d is equal to path loss at reference distance plus 10 n log d by d0, that is losses due to the exponent factor, plus x sigma. So PL bar of d denotes the average large scale path loss in dB at a distance d, that is TR separation distance, and x sigma is zero mean Gaussian or normal distributed random variable in dB with standard deviation sigma, which is also measured in dB. And PL bar of d0 is usually computed using free space propagation model that we discussed between the transmitter and receiver. Then expression 12, equation 12, takes into account the shadowing effect due to cluttering on the radio path. So cluttering is due to the obstructions. It is used as the propagation model for log normal shadowing environment. So the environmental parameters are very harmful to fluctuate the radio wave, and these are random in nature, and that's why one more term we assume, that is x sigma, that is a random factor with the exponent factor n. Then we can estimate the received power for this particular log normal shadowing. So received power in log normal shadowing environment is given by PR of d. So PR indicates the received power at distance d in dBm is equal to transmitted power minus path loss. So PT is nothing but transmitted power in dBm minus the path loss at same distance d in dB. So the expression we have written previously we can put here. So PR of d is equal to transmitted power in dBm minus the all the terms that we discussed earlier, that is PL bar of d0 path loss at reference distance plus losses due to the exponent factor plus one more term, that is x sigma in dB. So antenna gains are included in path loss of d. So these two main important terms are need to consider in the analysis of log normal shadowing, that is exponent factor n and sigma, standard deviation sigma. So log normal shadowing model indicates received power at distance d is normally distributed with a distance dependent. See, distance dependent mean with the standard deviation sigma. And in practice, the values of exponent factor and standard deviation, that is n and sigma, are computed from measured data using linear regression, so that difference between the measured data and estimated data or estimated path loss values are minimized in a mean square error sense. So simply the difference we are going to estimate, that is measured data and the estimated data. We'll see one example to determine the exponent factor and standard deviation sigma. Let us assume the received power at a reference distance is suppose 0 dB and D0 is suppose 100 meter. Then assume the receiver power, received power PR, which is measured at distance 100 meter, 500 meter, 1 kilometer and 3 kilometer, which is given in this table. So distance from the transmitter 100 meter, 500 meter, 1 kilometer and 3 meter, and received power the first 0 dBm, 5 dB, 11 dB and 16 dB. So the table gives the measured values of the received power. Now we know the measured values of the received power. Now we will compute the estimates for the received power at different distances using log distance path loss model, the equation that we discussed in previous slide, where PR of D0 is given 0 dB as per the table and measured value is also the same. So we can write mean of PR of D is equal to PR of D0 minus mean of path loss from D0 to D. Then mean of PR of D is equal to 0 minus 10 log, this term we discussed in previous equation number 11. So 10 log n D by D0. Then we will use this equation to compute the power levels at the different distances, that is 500 meter, 1 kilometer, 3 kilometer respectively. So average power, received power at 500 meter is equal to 0 minus 10 log n 500 by 100, we will get minus 6.99 n. For 1 kilometer of the power, we can write 0 minus 10 log n 1000 divided by 100, you will get minus 10 n. And for 3 kilometer, we will get minus 14.77 n. Now we have obtained the estimates and also measures the actual values of the received power at different distances. So in order to approximate n, that is exponent factor n, we have to choose the value for n such that mean square error over the collected statistics is minimized. So the mean square error we can write MSE is equal to square root of summation of I is equal to 1 to k of bracket pi minus p cap square, bracket square. So here pi is the actual measured value of power at some distance, p cap I is the estimate of power at that same distance, and k is the number of measurements or t samples. Since power estimate at some distance depend on n, so we are going to consider the mean square error with the exponent factor n, that is MSE of n is a function of n. Then we would like to find the value of n that will minimize the mean square error value. So we will call it as MMSE, that is minimum mean square error. So this minimum mean square error can be achieved by writing the MSE, mean square error, as a function of n, then finding the value of n which minimizes this function. This can be done by derivating the expression. So MSE of n with respect to n and solving for n, which makes the derivative equal to 0. So in this table, one more column is added, that is estimated value for received power in dBm that we have calculated. So for given distance 100 meter, it is 0. In both the cases it is 0. For 500 meter, as per the given table, it is 5 dB and estimated is 6.99 N. For 1 kilometer, it is minus 11 and estimated is minus 10 N. For 3 kilometer is minus 16 and estimated received power is minus 14.77 N. Then these values we can put in the expression that we have discussed in last slide, that is mean square error. So MSE is equal to 0 minus 0 bracket square plus the measured value minus the estimated value, that is minus 5 minus 6.99 N bracket square plus minus 11 minus or bracket minus 11 minus, sorry, minus 10 N bracket square plus minus 16 minus or bracket minus 14.77 N bracket square. Then by solving this equation, we can write mean square error is equal to 0 plus 6.99 N minus 5 bracket square plus 10 N minus 11 bracket square plus 14.77 N minus 16 bracket square. So if we open this, we get mean square error as a function of N, which as second order polynomial expression, so we can easily take its derivative and find the value of n which minimizes the mean square error. Now we are going to move towards the standard deviation sigma. For this, we will use the formula sigma square is equal to summation of the term that we discussed in last equation, summation of I is equal to 1 to k pi minus p cap bracket square divided by k. So here sigma square is the variance. We are going to find the standard deviation sigma. So here pi is the actual measured value of power at some distance, the same expression that we discussed in last equation. P cap is the estimate of power at that same distance d, k is the number of measurements for t samples. So from the above definition of sigma, we can derive that sigma square is equal to mean square error of n divided by k. Also we can write sigma square is equal to MMSE, that is minimum mean square error, as a function of n of as a function of n divided by k. And we can write the standard deviation expression for the standard deviation, sigma is equal to square root of MMSE by k. So n is the value that minimizes the mean square error. MMSE, the minimum mean square error, and MSE of n formula is given in the previous slides. So these are the few terms related to the statistics for the computation of the mu, that is mean variance, that is sigma square, and standard deviation sigma. Suppose we are having k number of samples with k values, that is x1, x2, x3 up to xk, then if we calculate the mean of these terms, then mean is denoted by mu, the variance is denoted by sigma square, the standard deviation is the sigma, then the formula to compute the mean, standard deviation and variance. So mu is equal to summation of I to k xi divided by k, where k is the number of samples. Sigma square is equal to summation of I to k so xi minus mu, that is mean bracket square divided by k. The standard deviation, square root of summation of I to k of bracket xi minus mu bracket square divided by n. Now path loss and the term received power. So in log normal shadowing environment, PL of D, that is path loss at TR separation distance, and received power PR of D are random variables with normal distribution in dB about the distance dependent mean. Sometimes we are interested in answering the questions like what is the mean received power, that is PR of D, or mean of received power at distance D from a transmitter, and what is the probability that received power PR of D in dB units at distance d is above or below some fixed threshold value, that is gamma, which is again expressed in dB power units such as dBm or dB milliwatt and dB watt. So the estimation of the mean power and the chances to get the power according to the design, that is for a fixed value of gamma, either we are getting the same power or either we are getting the power below the threshold value or we are getting the power above the threshold value. Then to find out the answer, we have to use the properties of the normal or Gaussian distribution. So received power, that is PR of D, is normally distributed, that is characterized by the mean mu and standard deviation sigma. These are the two main characteristics or the parameters are need to consider. So we are interested in probability that the received power is greater than or equal to the threshold value gamma, or the received power at distance d is less than or equal to the threshold value or threshold power gamma. So received power and normal distribution, PDF, that is probability distribution function. So in this figure we can able to see the PDF probability distribution function of normal distribution for received power PR of D at a fixed distance D with the mean mu is equal to 10 and standard deviation 5. So in this plot we can able to see on x axis the received power and on y axis the chances or the probability. So we can say that probability that received power PR is smaller than 3.3, that is probability that received power less than or equal to 3.3 is given with the value of stripped area under the curve. So in this plot we can able to see the received power is less than equal to 3.3, so here 3.3, and the area which is shown in this plot with stripped, which indicates the chances to get the power 3.3 or less than that. Then the normal CDF, that is cumulative distribution function. Now in this plot we can able to see CDF, that is cumulative distribution function of the normal distribution described in last slide. So probability of to get power less than or equal to 3.3 can be found by finding first point where the vertical line from the 3.3. So the received power 3.3, simply we will plot a vertical, we'll draw the vertical line on this curve and the plotting the same horizontal line on y axis. Okay, so we will get the chances, so which intersects the curve, and then by finding the corresponding point on y axis. So here we are getting point not 90123. So this corresponds to value of 0.09. So we can say that probability that to get the power less than or equal to 3.3 is 0.09. In the same way, if suppose the received power, if suppose 10 dB, again if we plot the line or if we draw the line on the curve, again by drawing the horizontal line on y axis, so here we are getting it is about 0.5, that is probability that to get the power 10 dB is 0.5. So in this way we can estimate or we can predict the signal power with the help of PDF and CDF, cumulative distribution function. In the next video lecture, we will discuss the outdoor propagation model.